Okay, guys. Coach, we'll go ahead and open with a statement, and then we will get your questions. Please use the raise your hand feature. Go ahead, Coach.
Well, I think that this was a really good win for us and our team this last week. I think our players really played hard in the game, played with a lot of toughness, showed a lot of resiliency, just kept fighting in the game. But I think that it also needs to be noted that probably the difference in the game, when you just look at the game totally, was turnovers. You know, we always talk about turnovers having a huge impact on the outcome of a game, and the turnovers, converting those turnovers to scores, when you really add it up, that was basically the difference in the game. So there are a lot of fundamental improvement things that we need to continue to focus on and work on, just about every individual, just about every unit, just about every group on our team has something that we need to focus on and do better. You know, some of those things could have been disastrous. We got the quarterback hit a couple times in a game that, you know, we could have been prevented. It wasn't like, you know, we couldn't block them. So they have, you know, when you play against really good players, you got to make sure you do a great job of executing, because they're always going to take advantage of any mistake that you make. I think it's really important, you know, this week that our I talked about this after the game. Our players have humility. That's what keeps you hungry in terms of what you have to do to improve and to play the next game. And I think everybody knows that this Tennessee game is, you know, a big rivalry game. Means a lot to a lot of people in the state of Alabama. And I'm sure that because it's a rivalry game, we're going to get the absolute, you know, best version of Tennessee's team. You know, Jeremy's done a really good job there, in my opinion. They played very, very well this year. You know, last week was a little bit of an anomaly, and again, that same old word comes up. You know, they turned the ball over, and that made a huge difference in the game. But they have some very capable players. I think they got two really good running backs. Quarterback's very athletic. They got some good skilled players outside. Their defense has played, you know, really well, you know, this year. They got really good pass defense. Their defense is like, you know, fourth or fifth in the league, you know, overall. They're very, very well coached. They do a good job on special teams. So we're going to see a good team. And they play their best against us. They beat some good teams this year when they played well, and they're very capable. And I would expect we'll see that kind of an effort from them this weekend.
Okay, we'll start things off with John Zehner from the Associated Press.
Yeah, Coach. Jeremy said it sounds like that Garantano, who you're obviously very familiar with, is going to have to kind of earn his job. So leaving that, even earn his starting job, do you prepare a little differently in case there might be a different guy, quarterback? Does that change your...
I don't really think we can. You know, they do a lot of things on offense. It's going to be very challenging for our defense to make the adjustments that they need to make, you know, in this game. I don't know. We don't have enough evidence to know how they would change what they do if they played somebody differently at quarterback. So I don't think we can prepare any different.
We'll go to Mike Rodak.
There was a point in fall camp when Dylan said he wasn't quite feeling himself and still had a little bit to go coming back from the injury. Just where do you think he's at this point, and how far away is he from where you might have expected him to be?
Well, I thought he played extremely well in this last game. He showed great leadership, really helped the other players play well. I think it was by far his best game in terms of execution, doing what he was supposed to do. So I feel like, you know, maybe that this was maybe will get him, you know, feeling confident in what he needs to, physically confident, so that he can go out there and continue to play well and perform well. But I thought he played extremely well in this game.
Go to Brett Hudson with the Tuscaloosa News.
Hey, Coach, we saw a lot of Jamil Burrows in that game compared to the previous three games. What did you see in his performance, and what does he add to the rotation when he's in it?
Well, you know, we were down a couple guys in the game. Without LeBron Ray playing, and, you know, that made us sort of give Jamel turns in practice. But he was doing a great job on the scout team. They were having a tough time blocking him over there. So we said, who's the next man up? So then, you know, we have another guy go down in the game, and, you know, it made us a little short. So we're going to continue to try to work him in, and hopefully he can continue to make progress.
Go to Charlie Potter.
Hey, Coach, just want to ask you for your thoughts on Will Riker's performance Saturday, especially that 52-yard field goal.
Well, he's the special teams player of the week this week, so, you know, he's done a really good job consistently kicking. Extra points, field goals have been good, practice and games. We're not doing as good a job, and it's not just him. We've worked different guys kicking off. We're not getting the ball where we need to get it, and we're not getting the kind of coverage we need to get. And that was a little bit of an issue in the last game for us, and that's one of the things we need to really work on improving this week.
Okay, let's go to Michael Casagrande with AL.com.
Yeah, Nick, there was a video after the game, the celebration in the locker room. It looked like a pretty emotional scene. It was later deleted, but what was that moment like for you, and how did you describe that time?
Well, it was an emotional game. I mean, you know, it was a big game. I love seeing the players have fun and enjoy themselves when, you know, they feel a sense of accomplishment, because we had a tremendous amount of respect for Georgia and the kind of team they had and what it was going to take to, you know, have a chance to be successful against them. And they were just really excited, and I was really happy to see them excited. You know, we've won games around here where we go in the locker room and, you know, everybody just kind of, you know, this is what everybody expects. And I hate that. I hate to see that. I think everybody should enjoy every win. They're hard to come by. The expectation sometimes gets to be that, yeah, well, you're Alabama, so you're supposed to beat this team, and if you don't beat them a certain way, then that's not good enough. And I don't really think that's fair to the players. These guys work hard. They put a lot into it. And I love to see them enjoy themselves when they have success. So I was very, very happy to see the players so happy.
Go to Tony Sakalas.
Kind of touching on that, you've mentioned keeping, you know, humble, and this was such an emotional win. What about your team do you feel is going to be able to handle that based on what they've already shown this year?
I really don't know if they can handle it, so we'll see if they can handle it. I haven't seen them since the game. I'm going to see them at 1:30 today, and we'll see how they work this week and how they play in the game. So I don't know how they're going to handle that. I don't – hypothetical questions, I can't really – I don't have a crystal ball. I hope they have enough maturity to handle it the way they need to, but we won't know until we practice all week, until we see how they play in the game.
Go to Steven.
First off, Coach, it was great seeing you back out there on the field over the weekend. And I guess for my question, Miller Forrestall started to catch even more passes in this offense. Where have you seen him become a more complete tight end?
Well, I think Miller's always played really well for us. We just had so many good skill guys around him that he hasn't had a chance to get the ball as much. But I think, you know, the way people are trying to play us now to take away Smitty, Waddle, you know, Jonathan, that, you know, the tight end has more opportunities, and we certainly hope to take advantage of those. But, you know, Miller's always been a really consistent player. He's very smart. He understands exactly what his role is and exactly what he needs to do to help the offense function, and has been very efficient and effective for us. So I'm happy to see that he is getting more involved in the passing game, and I think that's something that could be helpful to us in the future as well.
We'll go to David Pascal in Chattanooga.
Hey, Nick. Last year, obviously, Tennessee showed you tangible evidence of their improvement under Jeremy, winning 8 games, and they almost had you one possession game in the fourth quarter. Have you seen continued improvement from Tennessee this year, or is that kind of difficult given that they played 10 really good quarters and the last 6 quarters have kind of been nightmarish because of the turnovers?
Well, I think they have made progress. I think, you know, you look at what a team does down in, down out, how their players play. They're playing with a lot of effort, toughness. They're very well coached. They're in the right spots. But I think when you turn the ball over in this game, I don't care if it's us or them or whoever it is, it's really hard to overcome. You know, we do a little chart every week and show our players the record of every team in the country who's +3, +2, minus three, minus two, zero turnovers. And all you have to do is look at that chart, and it's very telling in terms of the impact that turnovers have on a game. And so I think that's been their issue. And it's not the rest of their team. It's not how they're capable of playing. It's not the progress that they've made. It's just, you know, the taking care of the ball.
We'll go to Haley Sutton.
Hey, Coach, one of the things we've seen Mac Jones excel in this year is really throwing that deep ball down and finding whichever receiver is open. How important has that been for your offense?
Well, I think Mac's done a good job. Every play, the quarterback makes a read in terms of where should I go with the ball and what should I do relative to what the defense is playing. So Mac has done a really, really good job of that. There's only been a couple occasions this year where we didn't feel like his eyes was in the right place, where, you know, he wasn't making the right decision. He's been very consistent with that, and that's really what has made and helped him be very effective in what he does. So he's smart. He understands. He prepares well, and I think those things are paying off for him.
Short on time here, we'll go with Edwin Stanton.
Hey, Nick, just a follow-up question on Miller Forrestall. Got hurt on the first play against Georgia. Just want to get your thoughts on the impact he has on this offense and what that did for y'all during his brief absence.
Well, I think that we didn't get off to a great start, but I think Georgia had a lot to do with that. We didn't do very well on third down in the beginning of the game. And how much of that was contributed to Miller not being in there, it's really hard to evaluate. I don't think it was totally because of that. There were other mistakes made, whether they were protection issues or something we didn't do right in the passing game, or it was, you know, they played really good and got us covered. So I can't really evaluate exactly. I know how much he means to us from a leadership standpoint, from a consistency and performance standpoint, and how that impacts and affects other players' confidence. But I do think that the other guys that went in the game in his place did a good job. So, you know, they got an opportunity, and I thought they responded fairly well.
Okay, we'll finish up with Rick.
Carly. Hey, Coach. Rick Carly in Birmingham, Channel 13. Your player pipeline to the NFL is huge. Tua got in the game yesterday for the Dolphins, played just a couple minutes, threw a couple passes. What's it mean to you as a head coach who has seen a kid like that go through such a devastating injury to be playing in the NFL? Just your comments on that.
Well, you know, we're always excited and happy for all of our players that they all have dreams of being able to play in the NFL someday. And you're really always happy and proud to, you know, see that dream come to fruition for them. Most guys don't have to go through what Tua went through in terms of the adversity that he had to overcome from an injury standpoint with the hip injury. But he worked hard. He's back to 100%. I'm glad to see that he's getting some opportunity to play now, and I hope that that continues, and I hope he does very well. We haven't had anybody in this program since I've been here that's been a better ambassador for the university, a better ambassador for the program than Tua has been. So, you know, our thoughts and prayers are always with him, and we hope that he does extremely well, and it surely won't surprise me if that's the case.
All right, Coach, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
We appreciate that. We'll be back with players here shortly.